Let me do a follow-up question. This one is directed at Ben and Monique. According to Pew Research, the net worth of white families in 2013 was $141,000. For black families, it was $11,000. Given this disparity, how can you argue that racism is not a driving factor in income inequality?
Because it has nothing to do with race and everything to do with culture. And when you have a culture that doesn't... You know what? Explain to me. You explain to me why black kids aren't graduating high school. Explain that one to me. Explain to me why black kids are shooting each other in rates significantly higher than whites are shooting each other. Explain to me why 13% of the population is responsible for 50% of the murder. Explain to me why the number of blacks and black kids in prison, not for innocent reasons, not for walking down the street and getting pulled into a prison, is so high. Explain, if it has nothing to do with culture, explain to me why the single motherhood rate in the black community jumped from 20% to 70% in the same course of time that the civil rights movement has made such tremendous strides. Is America more racist now than it was in 1960? And if it is, please explain to me how that happened.
Stop and frisk is racist because the vast majority of people who are stopped, Sally does obviously, believes that the vast majority of people who are stopped and frisked are black and Hispanic. That's because the vast majority of people in New York City who actually commit gun crimes are black and Hispanic.
And black and Latino folks are overrepresented in being pulled over and being sentenced and being tried and being sentenced and being incarcerated again and again and again and again and again. You don't believe it.
No, I mean, this is important. When it comes to jail, would you just like the vast, well over 90% of the people in jail are men? Is that because the system is really sexist against men? that the jailing system is now sexist against men because there are more men than women in prison? That's really your argument.
Now, it does happen also be the case that more men commit crimes.
There you go.
So this is the dumbest of all of the insults, the you're Islamophobic routine. If by Islamophobic you mean I'm very frightened of radical Muslims who want to kill me and my family, I suppose you're correct. I suppose that makes me Islamophobic. I'm not scared of the religion of Islam. I'm not scared of people who pray five times a day toward Mecca. I have nothing to say about that. I pray three times a day toward Jerusalem, right? I mean, there's nothing to say there. But when it comes to the argument that I'm Islamophobic because I oppose radical Islamic terror, that's because you are stupid. I don't think that they can be bought off by saying that ISIS needs jobs. So you're Islamophobic is a cop-out. It's a cop-out. I'm definitely scared of radical Islam, but it seems to me that if you're so scared of me saying radical Islam because you think that all Muslims are immediately going to turn into terrorists if I say radical Islam, then you're the one who's Islamophobic.
So here with more, Ben Shapiro.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Editor-in-chief of DailyWire.com with his thoughts on this controversy. Ben, good evening to you. You heard our conversation and you heard the piece of sound there from Mark Lamont Hill talking about mediocre Negroes that he said were paraded, basically to check boxes for Donald Trump. What do you think?
I mean, I think, first of all, anybody who says that somebody is a mediocre Negro because they disagree politically makes you a less than mediocre person. I mean, it's really quite a disgusting thing to say. And I don't think it's intellectually honest for Professor Dyson to be talking about how they were just wanting someone with more expertise. The idea that the left can object to celebrity involvement in politics, I didn't see them whining and crying when Meryl Streep was ripping Donald Trump up and down over the Golden Globes. I saw them celebrating her heroism for wearing
that,
a $12,000
right?
Ball gown in front of all of her friends.
Don't back down, niggas! Back down, niggas! Murder, my murder, nigga! Kill him, nigga, kill him! Leave him slumped back!